My name is Rajib Mal. I am the instructor for this course. I'll first briefly tell about myself before discussing about the contents of the course. I completed all my degrees, bachelor's, master's and PhD degrees from the Indian Institute of Science at Bangalore. That's the picture of my institute where I studied. And then worked for a few years at Motorola, India, and then shifted to IIT Kharagpur in 1994. And currently, I am a professor in the Computer Science and Engineering Department, and that's the picture of my institute. Before we look at the plan of the course, let's look at the motivation about the course very briefly. I'll give the motivation for the course with the help of a simple analogy. Let's say you procured a sophisticated gun, and this is the gun. You were a proud owner of this nice gun, used to display it to your friends and so on, take pride in the gun, but then hardly had any opportunity to use the gun. But then opportunity arose and you used it. You saw a mosquito and then you used the gun to kill the mosquito. And then you claimed that you were good at using the gun. Things are not very different for Java programmers. You learned Java. You learned the syntax and semantics. You have written small programs that work. And then you often used to take pride that you have written programs, and you claim that you are an expert object-oriented software developer. And this syndrome is not restricted to students alone. Even professionals working in companies, we see the same thing, that with small Java experience, they claim to be good Java software developer or object-oriented software developer. This course is meant for learners who have knowledge of Java, and it is intended to fill the gap where their basic knowledge of Java and to be a good object-oriented software developer, where their program can be used for many years for large programs, maintainable and so on. We'll start with some very basic concepts in this course, and then we'll discuss about UML, the Unified Modeling Language, which has become the de facto standard in documenting object-oriented designs and also used in the design process. And then we'll look at a design process which we'll use for designing, and this is based on UML. And after that, we'll discuss few important object-oriented principles. These are good principles that form the cornerstone of writing good object-oriented programs. And these principles, in fact, form the backbone or the base for the design patterns. The design patterns are solutions to some standard problems which have been developed by expert programmers. If we know these design patterns, we can use them in any design problem that we try to solve, and we can see that the quality of our problem solution really enhances. And we will about one third of the course we look at UML and designing UML, and rest we'll look at the object oriented principles and design patterns. That's the plan for this course. We'll stop here. Thank you.